Hey, what's up everybody? It's Dan here. In this video, I want to talk about something called investor attention and how that relates to earnings announcements, and ultimately, what implications does that have for you as an investor? If you're new to the channel, my name is Dan. I'm a business school professor focused on accounting and finance. I do a lot of videos on investing, so if you like that kind of thing, hit that subscribe button to check out more videos like this one. All right, let's jump into it. All right, guys, so in this video, I want to talk about this idea of limited attention in financial markets. It's kind of a challenge to the efficient market hypothesis. If you guys don't know, the efficient market hypothesis is an idea put forward by academics that, you know, any stock at any point in time fully incorporates any public information into its price almost instantly. It's one of those ideas that's so crazy, only academics could love it. But assuming you're not an academic, you're just a normal person, you don't have permanent head damage, you know that markets are not efficient at all times for all stocks. And one of the things that ensures that markets will never be fully efficient is limited attention. There are so many stocks to trade. There are so many events happening all the time. We don't even know which events will affect which stocks in which ways. It takes time to process all of that information, and by the time you processed it, some other news event came out about interest rates or consumer demand for this or that. So there's always more information to process. So I want to talk about one particular situation where investor attention is particularly stretched thin, and that is earnings season, which is happening right now. We have hundreds of earnings announcements every day for the past few weeks, and it's continuing this week. So as I make this video, it's actually Sunday, February 21st. You can see we have 102 earnings announcements coming up tomorrow, and we have even more throughout the week, really topping out on Thursday with 344 earnings announcements. Interestingly, only 48 earnings are being announced on Friday. Does that mean something? Can we learn anything from the day of the week a firm announces their earnings? Actually, yes. A study in the Journal of Finance shows that Friday earnings announcements are typically associated with weaker stock price reactions. The reason, they argue, is limited investor attention on Fridays, people thinking about the weekend ahead. In the same year, another study in the Journal of Finance finds that, investors have weaker reaction to earnings announced on days where there are many other earnings announcements. So what we have here is essentially information overload. Too many companies to follow at once, you're going to have weaker market responses to most of their earnings. Okay, so you're probably asking yourself, would CEOs take advantage of this? Do they even realize that investors pay less attention on Fridays or the other busy days? They wouldn't, would they? CEOs are good people. Well, researchers have shown that yes, CEOs do take advantage of this. They look at companies that change their pattern, companies that go from always announcing their earnings on a Monday or a Tuesday, for example, to announcing all of a sudden on a Friday or a very busy earnings day. And they find that on average, when companies make this kind of schedule change, they tend to be reporting bad news. All right, guys, so two key takeaways thus far. Number one, you can take advantage of other people's limited attention if you want to. If you're going to focus in on just a few companies you have large positions in, maybe, you can possibly act quicker in response to earning news compared to other investors who are focused on too many companies. The second takeaway is that, yes, it actually does matter when a company announces their earnings. On average, if a company chooses to break the pattern and make an announcement on Friday or announce on a very busy day with lots of other companies announcing, that actually says something about what the earnings are going to be, so you can use that information to your advantage. Let's have a look at a few other situations where limited attention comes into play in the stock market. All right, guys, so one area we can use limited attention to your advantage is with major customers. Here I'm at the SEC's website, the SEC EDGAR system. You can look up companies' 10-Ks. I'm in the notes to the financial statements. And what I see here is for Bristol-Myers Squibb, their sales to their three largest customers here. For example, in 2020, sales to McKesson, 31%, AmerisourceBergen, 25%, and Cardinal Health, 19%. So can we use the information about their customers to help predict their returns? Well, research would say yes. A study in the Journal of Finance finds that when you look at the stock returns of a company's major customers in any given month, on average, that helps predict the stock returns of that company for the following month. So with Bristol-Myers Squibb, for example, if we look at the average returns of Cardinal Health, AmerisourceBergen, and McKesson in any given month, that can help us predict Bristol-Myers Squibb return in the following month. Finally, as another example of how limited attention presents opportunities in financial markets, we have this paper here called Complicated Firms. The researchers here argue that some firms are inherently more complicated than others. Companies like Amazon, for example, have several business segments. So what the authors do is they examine events that will affect every company within a certain industry. And what they find is that companies that have a single business segment in that industry, their stock prices react first. The companies that are more conglomerates with multiple segments will react slowly. And so that gives you an advantage. If you know that, you can then trade on that. You can take advantage of that information before others. So for example, in the grocery industry, you know, Amazon owns Whole Foods. They're in the grocery business, but they have a lot more going on besides that. So if we have a shock to the grocery industry, some kind of law enacted, maybe the minimum wage law raised to $15 an hour that would affect all grocery stores' profitability, the other grocery stores are likely to have stock prices react much quicker compared to Amazon, for example. All right, guys, so in conclusion, limited attention in financial markets is a real thing. It is something to be aware of. There is some information out there. If you really dig into it, you can possibly have an advantage over other investors. Paying attention to things like, you know, what are a company's major customers? How are they performing? Paying attention to when earnings are being announced. Paying attention to whether the company has changed their schedule for announcing earnings. You know, these things are a lot of work to follow, but they can result in payoffs for you. Well, I know you guys all have limited attention as well, so I'm going to end the video right here. Thank you so much for watching.